many inaugurations, right? You've seen this. You've seen the tradition of it, which is, I think, part of what makes, you know, people get goosebumps. That is what's so important about this. Donald Trump is has sort of the kind of guy who always wants to throw tradition away. But today, he's really stuck with it. He did that at the Lincoln Memorial. He had the concert there. He's been very traditional. Where do you expect him to be unconventional tomorrow, to break tradition?
Well, for all my sins, I think this is my 11th inauguration. and listen, I think in general he showed today a solemnity that we haven't ordinarily associated with Donald Trump. It did seem, as Doug said earlier on, that it was now beginning to hit him. Yeah, because you can't be surrounded by that. You know, you're surrounded by so many soldiers. That in part is pomp and circumstance. You just get a sense of the enormous authority that goes with the office. But he was still Donald Trump today. I mean, he, you know, that preposterous statement that he had the
highest
cabinet
IQ
with the
of
highest
any cabinet
collective
ever.
IQ of any cabinet in history. Really? I think even Rick Perry would say, look, you know, he was preceded in his office by the chair of the physics department at MIT, and his predecessor was a Nobel Prize winner, and Rick Perry had a somewhat different upbringing and a different professional place. So I don't think we're going to see Donald Trump disappearing, the old Donald Trump. And I also think that there's going to be an enormous amount of controversy as he starts down this substantive
path. And what about the speech itself? You know, he tweeted out a picture of himself that he said he was writing at Mar-a-Lago, and a lot of people said, oh, there's nothing on that paper. They're not giving him the credit for it. You've talked to him about the speech. You, he